إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah. We seek refuge with Allah from our sins and bad deeds. He who is guided by Allah indeed has been guided. And he who is misguided, only Allah Azza wa Jal can guide him. And I bear witness that there is no deity to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon Sayyidina Muhammad, upon his family, upon his companions, and upon those who follow his sunnah until the day of judgment. Amen. The best words are the words of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are at the doors of Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. Ramadan, the month that Quran was revealed in it. Ramadan is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preferred over all other months. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth, created time. And Allah, from the earth, Allah favored certain places as Mecca and Bayt al-Maqdis and so forth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preferred from time that He subhanahu wa ta'ala created certain times over others. And that time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored one of the months, or the months, the whole months that Allah preferred over other months, is the month of Ramadan. And the time of Ramadan, actually it is the time that Allah created, since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. Meaning that throughout history, mankind manipulates the calendar. A calendar go by seasons, a calendar go by a death or a birth of someone, a calendar goes by, you know, different things, by agriculture, when to plant and when to harvest. But the calendar that is according to how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heaven and the earth, or when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heaven and the earth, is the moon calendar. The sun calculate the day and night, and the moon calculate, or with it we calculate the month. So the Arabs were, before the Ba'tha of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was using that calendar. However, they were using it in a way with the four sacred months. The four sacred months that are the one that once it arrives, they will not fight. The months that are haram, meaning the wars, instead it becomes a state of peace immediately. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confirmed those months that to become months that are haram, months that are peaceful and one should not fight in it and so forth. However, before the Ba'th of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Arabs used to manipulate the calendar, meaning that they used to, in a time of war, for example, you know, month Muharram or Dhul Qa'da or Dhul Hijjah, though there are months that are haram months, if there's still 3 or 4 months to reach one of them and they want to stop a war, so they go to those who are calculating the calendar or holding the calendar and tell them, please, can you bring this month forward 2 or 3 months so we can stop fighting? So they had this practice of moving and manipulating months, moving it forward, bringing it back, and so forth. So actually, time was not matching the time of when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. In other words, Ramadan was not Ramadan exactly as it Ramadan is, and so forth. But when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made his Hajj, he stood on the mountain of Arafat and sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us that this point of time, the time now matches at the time when Allah created the heavens and the earth. Remember that the time of Arafat, this standard in that day in Hajj, it is a day that is the act of worship that is calculated by time and place. The only day that is the act of worship is calculated by time and place. It has to be a certain time and a certain place. All other acts of worship either have to do with time or have to do with place. So prayer, a salah, has to do with time. You pray wherever, it doesn't matter where you are, but it is time. Okay. Ramadan, you fast anywhere, but it's a time of that month of Ramadan. Hajj, it is a time and a place. Umrah, it is a place, it's not a time. You go for Umrah any time during the year, but then when the Hajj comes, you go to a specific place at a specific time. Within Hajj, there is a specific day and a specific mountain you have to be on. And Al-Hajj Arafah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, meaning Hajj is Arafah. Anything else in Hajj that you miss or you make up and so forth, you could slaughter a key for it and so forth, and you make it up. However, that standing on the mountain of Arafah is, it has you cannot make it up with any other action. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this is matching now the time. So the point being is Ramadan that is coming within a few days is matching the time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. We need to understand that. We need to look at this as something very special. It is not something that we favored. It is something that a time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Quran in it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the opportunity to know exactly when it is, and give us the opportunity to believe in it and anticipate it as it's coming, and to be participant in it. This is a blessing. Now, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا جَاءَ رَمَضَان, when Ramadan arrives, فُتِّحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ, the doors of Jannah are opened. And in love of Muslim, in the hadith, the same hadith that is in Sahih Muslim, فُتِّحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الرَّحْمَةِ, the doors of Rahmah are opened. So, literally, the doors of Jannah and the doors of Rahmah are open when the time, the month of Ramadan arrives. When we in our life look at something that is beneficial, we try to arrive to it, go to it, achieve the place and time where you can find it, especially if the reward, it is tangible immediately right in front of you. You know, we have our youth. I remember one of the youth one day, he said, tonight he's going to, and some of them, not just one, we're going to sleep in the street. In the street. Why? Waiting for a certain store to open. Why? It's because there is a sale. Turn that off or take it out of the masjid. That there is a sale that is happening, and actually he was not there to buy it so he can, you know, in sales he can save money. No, he said it is only that day, so we're going to buy the item and then wait for a couple of days and sell it in the market so we can make some money. The point being is, when we know that the issue is very tangible in front of us, we can calculate how we can achieve that profit. And we know exactly what to expect. Last week we talked about the Israelites and the first information Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us about them, that they did not connect the cause and effect, or connect the effect is to the cause, meaning the means that they are taking, they connect it to the result that they are getting. And when they got the results from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they could not stand it. When they were in the desert getting and manna wa salwa and the water from the stone in front of them and the cover with the shade of the clouds and so forth, they could not stand it. Because their relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was not strong. They wanted something tangible, to calculate when they're going to get the food, so get us from what the earth brings. We put the seed now, we water it, and we know where it's going to give us. So you trust the earth, you trust the means that you're taking, more that you trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what is our relationship with Ramadan? So when we talk now about the rahmah, the mercy of Allah is open. Okay, the doors of mercy are open. When we talk about the Jannah, paradise, the doors of it are open. Do we take this as something really tangible, almost tangible in front of us? Or do we just say, yeah, we know. And we're not really into understanding this in our hearts, our intellect. If we really understand this and believe in that, and recognize that the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is coming, then definitely we will walk into this month into the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and try to take from it as much as we can. Literally, we are in an abundance that is coming. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, come to this abundance. So, you might achieve taqwa. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبِلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. It is written upon you, fasting like it was written upon those before you, or you believe, Allah talked to the believers. So you might achieve taqwa. They achieve the righteousness, achieve to be conscious of Allah, to be have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hudud, do's and don'ts, do this and don't do that. To reach a level of righteousness that is higher than the one that you started with. This is the prescription to reach that, is fasting. Now, all the concept of fasting itself, it's special. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in hadith, that is hadith ilahi, hadith Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that all the amal of ibn Adam lahu, all the work of the son of Adam is for him. Illa siyam fahuwa li. Except fasting, it is for me, and I will reward my servant when I see him, when he comes to me. So here is, fasting is special now, very special, not like any other act. Why? Why? Remember, there is the circle of Islam, the circle of Iman, and the circle of Ihsan. We say the one who is a Muslim, it is a'mal al-jawarih. It is the work of the limbs. You need to pray, okay, and you need to fast. You need to pay zakah, and you need to go to hajj. It's a physical. And iman, that circle of iman, of the circle of belief, it is smaller, and it is within the circle of Islam, which is the circle of the amal al-qulub, the circle of working with the hearts, right? Meaning the heart is connected to Allah and His angels and His messengers and the books and the day of judgment and the qadr, the fate, the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all this is understanding with the heart, believing in it. Okay? So now the maqam al-ihsan and the circle of ihsan, it is to do more of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking you to do in a beautiful way, okay, and in a way of love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now, what is fasting in this? When Jibreel alayhi salam came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in a shape of a man, as the hadith of Umar radiallahu anhu said that a man came to us and Shadidu Bayadu Thiyab, that his clothes are very white and his hair is very dark and black, does not look like he's been traveling and no one knows him. In other words, it's something very strange. Either everybody knows him or he's a traveler. Nobody knows him and does not look like a traveler. Anyway, he came into and asked about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what is Islam and what is Iman and what is Ihsan? And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered him. Ihsan is, Islam is the pillars of Islam, that we know, the five pillars, the Iman, the pillars of Iman that we just mentioned, and Ihsan, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. To worship Allah as if you see Allah, and if you do not see Allah, Allah sees you. Now, fasting. If you are all sitting in the month of Ramadan together, we assume all of us are fasting. But we do not for sure know if all of us are fasting or not. It is something between one and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When one goes alone into a place, they can actually break their fast and eat. They can eat, but they will not. Why? If they have taqwa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will not. Now, they worship Allah as if they see Allah, and as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees them. It becomes a special relationship, no one would know it. No one would know it. So it becomes in the touch and the level of ihsan. In the level that's very special level. So when you are in such place of worship, of state of worship, and the doors and the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is open, now the level of iman, it's getting higher. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that the one who keeps on wudu all the time is a believer. What does that mean? here is a person who keeps his wudu all the time. Meaning, he's breaking his state of purity and then he would go and make wudu again. But see, no one knows that he is not in a state of wudu. No one would know that. And if he's breaking his wudu, he does not have to renew it unless he's getting ready for prayer. But if he is aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he wants to be in that state, and he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that he broke his wudu, that he's no longer in a state of wudu, then he goes make wudu. That's a special relationship, no one would know it. Except one and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is a maqam al-ihsan. That is a beautiful state that one is in. So when we are fasting for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now we are aware that we have to go to the extra level of ihsan. We are truly fasting physically, and we are holding back in our tongue. We are holding back in our temper. We're not angry, we hold ourselves. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that when somebody gets you angry, do not get angry back at them. And if you find yourself getting angry, say what? Inni mu'insan. I am a man who is fasting. In other words, remind yourself. You find yourself going into the reactions. You're going to react to something. Somebody push you, want to push him back. Someone insult you, want to insult him back. This is a reaction. Rasulullah said, when you find yourself going to react, say, I am a person who is fasting, I'm fasting. In other words, remind yourself with that state. Remind yourself that you are fasting. So you get back into that state. So you get back into realizing what ihsan, the level of ihsan that you are in. Now, when we know that the doors of our rahmah are open, and we are in it, we want to grab from it as much as we can. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, what can we grab? For fasting, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر الله له ما تقدم من ذنبه. The one who fasts the month of Ramadan, believing and knowing the reward, expecting the reward and knowing the value of it, and do it in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all his sins will be forgiven. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban. The one who stands in Ramadan, meaning stand in prayer, meaning do the Taraweeh prayer, not necessarily the whole Quran throughout the month and so forth, but finds the night as a place and a time, and as a time for prayer, after Isha prayer. He who stands in Ramadan, qama Ramadan, meaning all the month, not necessarily all night or the whole juz and so forth, but part of the night. إِمَانًا مَحْتِسَابًا غُفَرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. He will be forgiven, Allah will forgive what he presented or he has from sins. Then Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ. مَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ. The one who stands, meaning stands the night of Qadr, which is that one of the odd nights at the last 10 nights of Ramadan, then إِمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفَرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. He will be forgiven, his sins will be forgiven for him. This is the door of rahmah that is open for the fasting. And then more that is open in the qiyam. And then more that is open in just one night in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us, wants to forgive us, open the doors for us, and tell us, come, and I will forgive you. See, it is one level that you run, so will be forgiven. And another one, to run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to thank Allah for what Allah has given you. This is a whole different point. Meaning, if we think about the bounties, the gifts, the barakah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in our lives, and we take advantage of this time of Ramadan and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the gifts that Allah has given us, that is also a whole different door that we need to enter. Okay? And how do we get there? We get there first by looking at oneself. Looking at the mind, the same mind that Allah has given us. The understanding that when you read something, you're able to understand it. When you hear something, you're able to reflect on it. When you eat something, it benefits you. And you eat many, many things, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you so many things that you eat, and it's all benefiting you. And some other people only eat limited food because other food will harm them. You have a place to stay every night you go to, and a sakina you find in your place. You have a family that you go to that is taking care of you, and you're taking care of them. You have an air conditioner at home that you turn in the middle of Ramadan, in the middle of the day, so you could get some easiness in fasting. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you a gift of being able to know that this is Ramadan. Giving you the gift of being a Muslim and a mu'min and a Muslim. Giving you a gift to we don't know if any of us are going to get this gift or not, to be alive when Ramadan comes. We don't know if we're going to get this gift. So when we get it and you enter Ramadan, this should be a celebration. Should be a celebration itself that you are healthy, you are sane, you have the knowledge, and you hear that someone's seen the moon somewhere in the earth, and you rejoice. Because here are the doors of Rahmah are open, and now Allah has given you that chance to enter. It should be itself a minute of celebration. The ghaib, that is ghaib. That is ghaib. But that ghaib, the unseen, it is coming to us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through the Quran and Sunnah. So this ghaib, we know that existing, and we are certain in it more than we are certain with things that we can touch with our own hands. Yes? The time will come soon, and those who are blessed, they will enter in this rahmah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us, keep us alive until we enter Ramadan. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله جل وعلا فادعوه استجب. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين ورحمة الله للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد في القرآن الكريم إن الله لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. Allah will not change what's happening to people unless they change what's happening within themselves. It is time to change what's happening within ourselves. Ramadan is coming. Reaching within oneself to investigate the faults that we each individual of us are carrying. And look of the diseases of the heart that we have, and try to seek the remedies from worship and fasting and qiyam and siyam and dua and istighfar, so we can change deeply or truly what's in within ourselves. So when we all come out of Ramadan, things will change for us that's happening to us. The whole ummah is going through difficulties. All the Muslims all over the world are going through difficulties. It is time to reach deep in our heart and really try to change ourselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that He's going to change what's happening to us. It is a promise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His promise is going to be fulfilled. It is a guarantee from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a time to investigate. When Musa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, go to the Pharaoh, he said, Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdata min lisani yafqahu qawli. What did he do? He looked at himself and his chest was tight. So he said, oh Allah, I want my chest open now and ready. Oh Allah, I do not speak very eloquently. My tongue is heavy. Could you just untie one knot on my tongue so they can understand what I'm saying? Oh Allah, give me my brother Harun to be with me to help me in this matter. In other words, he investigated his what he needs and asked Allah what he needs. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ أُتِيتَ سُؤْلَكَ يَا مُوسَى. You are given what you asked for, Musa. And here is your brother, and go. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided them. We need to do some investigation and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua for these deficiencies to be fixed. Oh Allah, I have envy. I tend to envy, you know, to see things of this dunya and I sort of like want to go after it. Oh Allah, take this out of my heart, ya Allah. Allah, my head gets heavy in the time of Fajr. I always pray subh after the time of Fajr, after sunrise. Oh Allah, help me in this so I can and make dua sincerely. Allah will answer your dua. Oh Allah, I have a tongue that is sharp. I tend to insult people and so forth. Oh Allah, please, ya Allah, get my tongue softer and so forth. And we all have deficiencies. We need to directly ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer our dua. So at the end of Ramadan, we'll be a lot of individuals together, but together we'll be a qawm. A qawm. Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma bi qawm. So here is, Allah will not change what's happening to a group of people. Meaning what's happening to you is general. It's touching everyone. But for that to change, you have to change. Each one of you change. You see the point? Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say, okay, you change your system that you're using. Change this all collectively. No, individually you need to change. So collectively, that change will happen to you. Let's put this in our mind. What is it that we want in Maryam Center here? What is it that we want for our kids, our children? What is it that we want for relationship between each other? What is it that we want and so forth? You want all the, you know, to make a changes, you know, and to be used by the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the difficulty of this place, and we want a bigger one so we can do more service and for the kids and youth and so forth. Do we know this? These changes Allah will bring, but we need to deserve it. We need to be ready for it. We need to reach and change. And when Allah sees that we change, Allah will change what's happening to us. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that Allah does not look at your outside and the deeds that you do. Okay, meaning that the wealth that you have and the looks on the outside. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yanzuru ila qulubikum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at your heart, inside of you, who you are inside. And when we know that Allah knows what's in us, in the inside of us, we'll be too shy and ashamed that the inside will not be good. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with us. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusallina ala nabi.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه إلى يوم الدين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أنت أعلم بما في قلوبنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا. اللهم أنت أعلم بحاجتنا منا فاقضها لنا. اللهم أنت أعلم بسرنا وعلانيتنا فتقبل معذرتنا. اللهم اجعل لنا إيمانا صادقا في قلوبنا حتى نعلم أنه لا يصيبنا إلا ما كتبته لنا ولا ننال إلا ما كتبته لنا. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وقوم إلى الصلاة يا حبيبي.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.